What, it's already live? What the F? Hello everyone and welcome back to another Rise of Kingdom live stream. My name is Legend Ronnie and today we have one versus one fights. Or maybe not, we just might have a very chill live stream, you know, chill out, listen to some good music and so on. I was expecting to press the button to go live. I'm not sure why it went straight on the live stream. It's just crazy. Yo, I'm so old school with these things, trying to getting a hang of it. Anyways, Killer, hey, how are you doing? Yagu, the Whisper, Raising, Alir, Tata Batin, K Stanford, how are you doing all? Welcome. Stark, hello. Welcome everyone, welcome to the live stream. Okay, one versus one, army fight. Just trying to post on my Discord as well, so I'll be back in the chat in just a moment. I feel like being very chatty, to be honest. Let me go ahead, press it on YouTube. How are you all doing? How is your Friday night? Christian, hello. Wesley, Santos, Indra, Born Again, and Kit, Saif, hello. Official, Jokiha, hello bro. Did you watch Romans of the Three Kingdoms? Yes, I did watch one episode when Lubu was fighting the three brothers. It's quite alright, just not on my taste. Kai Stanford, hey. 412 or 411 is win. We will find out at the end of the KVK. Romance of the Three Kingdom, is that a movie? I think that's a series. Shiny. Who doesn't want something shiny? Right? Okay, let me get this over here. Let me get this over here. Hello, hello, Totslayer. How are you all doing? Will there be any tutorial regarding Race Against Time? Well, what tutorial would you need against Race Against Time? I've talked in every video that I've done regarding Race Against Time where you can find the spot. This is the tutorial. Even talked in the last update where I talked about the Thanksgiving event. Even there I mentioned about it. I like your style of explaining. I'm glad you like it. It's a series. Alright, so Romans of the Three Kingdoms is a series. Oh my god, some people. We do have the altars open, and I know there is some fights going on over here or not. I'm not 100% sure. But if I go there, I need to pop a boost. So let me pop a 5% boost. Let me pop a 25 expansion. Let's see if I get the rune as well. Maybe we can get some 1v1 battles. No runes. Training. When you don't need it. Let's see, resource gathering, commander, food gathering, action points recovery, wood. Exactly what you need for fighting. All the gathering possible. Let's see, what do we have on this one? Ooh, attack and defense, 5%. That's quite all right. Commander experience, resource building, attack and march speed training. I'm gonna go for attack and defense. All right, let me get the speedy march over there, just like that. Ronnie, what's your starting talent using in Ark? It's the same as the one in the Discord. It depends if I use him with Takeda or not. Let's see what talent I have now. No, this is the one without Takeda. When I use him with Takeda or double C, I take counterattack. I drop the buckler shield and I get the counterattack. But right now I use him with Genghis. I do Sardin and Genghis, and that's what I use. Or Sardin and YSG, I use the same talent tree. Who is in your MG? We have Artemisia. And it's also kill event. Alright, let me get a couple of marches out. I need to put equip. Hold on. What would you want to see in the testings? Yo, yo, Ronnie, how are you? I'm fine, thank you, Mohammed. Welcome to the stream. Ronnie, is it true OV split up? I didn't hear anything about it. When is Ruin gonna start? Wanna see some action. Oh, the Ruins. The Ruins is tomorrow. Or when is it? Let me check. It's the same time, it doesn't matter. Let's see. Oh, the next Ruin is in 14 hours. Holy smokes. When is 14 hours from now? It's 7. Put another 5 hours and that's 12. Wow, that's gonna be 9:40 in the morning. That's tomorrow morning for me. 9:40 Saturday morning. So I need to wake up around 8, I guess. Definitely. Surip, Surip, hey, what's up? Welcome. Can you show your Goa new talent? Yeah, I can show you my Goa new talent. If it's so hard to go on Discord and get it from there, I can show you my Goa new talent. This is my Goa new talent. And believe it or not, with Feral Nature, and I still generate rage slower than other people. I don't know why. Sometimes I do the first kill. But sometimes I don't, and I just don't understand. Anyways, that's my talent tree. Yunus, how are you doing? Hello, welcome to the stream. For Kingsland, I have a different talent tree. But this is for Sunset Canyon. Just to understand, I use it in Ruins, the same talent. But when I go in Kingsland, I have a different talent that I'm going to use. I don't care about Feral Nature when I go in Kingsland. This is the one that I use in Kingsland or when I go on open fields. So I'm gonna reset his talents for that purpose. But right now is for Sunset Canyon, I need this one and I use it in Ruins as well. It's not a big difference. Nathan, I'm alright. Welcome. Do a Guan Mehmed, Ronnie. I'm not doing really Guan Mehmed. If you wanna try some more solid pairs, try Saladin Takeda. I can try Saladin Takeda, but I don't have the talent trees. And I'm not gonna reset the talent trees for counterattack. Just for this. Where is it? Yeah, this is the one with counterattack. I can do it without it, I guess. There's Guan Alex versus Guan Leo. I already tested that in some of the previous live stream. After Alex, should I go for Guan or Harald? I recommend Guan. Edward Talent Tree? Yeah, I can show you Edward Talent Tree. This is when you pair him with Tomiris. Because right now I use Edward and Tomiris. It's with the full Archer and rest on the skill. And if you want to do Edward and YSG, this is the one that you want. Edward YSG or Edward and anything else, really. But if you do Edward and Tomiris, this is the talent that you want. I run out of resources for kill event, so come here. KVK2 and kill event. Saladin Attila defeat Saladin Takeda. Really? Alright, you know what? Let's try Saladin Attila then. You know, let's try some weird combos. Why not? Let me put equipment on this guy. Let me put a Silent Trial as well. And I'm gonna take out Saladin Attila. Let's see what we can do with a Saladin Attila then. I don't think it's gonna be a lot of good results, but let's try. That's very interesting for me as well to try. Hello Ronnie, the Three Kingdoms in Lost Kingdom 102-1. Eyebrow, well, congratulations to you if that's the truth. Should I max Guan first or Alex? Well, if you go on the chronological order, you get Alex like 6 months before Guan Yu. So I'm not sure why you're really asking should I max Alex or Guan first. I'm not saying that you'll max a legendary in 6 months, but would you really wait that long until you unlock Guan Yu the Avenger? Alex has more utilities overall. Plus Guan Yu is useful from 5-1-1-1. So get Alex done first. Because at least Alex has a very nice expertise. You want to try weird combos? Do Ramses Saladin versus Khan YSG. Anything full DPS. Let's see first if anyone comes out to fight. You know? Because they usually don't like to do one versus one. They usually just group fight. So they get good trades. Trying to get there as fast as possible. Going from tiles to tiles. I need resources, Ronnie. Can I zero you? Yes. Please. I want to get rid of this. Ahmed, how are you? How are you doing? Hello, Ronnie. How are you? I'm fine, thank you. For events, is Alex or Khan better? For PvE, I would say that Genghis Khan is way better for PvE events. I use Genghis Khan even in this day, even in this present, even in these ruins. And this is my 6th KVK. And I don't regret a single bit investing in Genghis Khan. It's just that people don't play properly with Genghis Khan. That's the difference. You need to know how to play with Genghis Khan. He's not a commander that... If you want to do PvP with Genghis Khan, you need to play carefully. But for PvE events, I think Genghis Khan is one of the best. I don't think there is a better commander than Genghis when it's about PvE events. Genghis and YSG, they just demolish any kind of event when it comes to damage. Oh my god, Forefield is there as well? Well, they're not gonna come out. Who else is there? Konjo, Badran. Yeah, they're not coming out. We've been fighting all day. I thought they might want to fight a little bit more. Where is it? Turn off screen flickering. It's busy. How are you doing? Good morning. Why you jump on wood nodes? Who needs wood? I need wood. I farm wood. Trust me. Sounds crazy, but I do. I do farm wood. The Saladin Takeda win against an Attila Takeda in 1 versus 1. I believe it depends on the luck as well, to tell you the truth. Hey Ronnie, how's fights going? Very entertaining. There's lots of fights going on. Ronnie, are you next Ruins at 9:40 UTC? Lillian, yes, 9:40 UTC tomorrow. What commanders come to your mind after reading my name? Chandra Gupta? Okay, Rona Miller is coming out. CJ Bot is coming out. Well, it's a 3-on-2 situation, and CJ Bot is also retreating, so. Come on, bro, come on this direction. Fight with me. Oh, hold on. Come on, Billy. What's your name? Bill. Yeah, that's it. Come this direction. Come, let's go away from these guys. Stop fighting them. Come fight with me. Come on, I want to try Saladin Attila. Oh my god. Look at these guys. Beta, how are you doing, brother? Hello. Welcome to the stream. How's things going for you? Recently, no, I'm using Minamoto. Well, I do use him when I rally forts. One versus one, Chandra William beats all cast pairing, even after update. Well, when I'm gonna get them in about 4 months, I'll be able to test it. Heroni, do you ever think about migrate to younger kingdoms like 1800, 1900? Defa, no, because I like challenge. That's why I play the game. I don't plan to migrate and make super mega whale kingdoms to steamroll KVKs. I don't see fun in that. I see fun in having a challenge. When you fight people, not when you just overwhelm other kingdoms with numbers. I mean, that's just me. If you can get a challenge of a similar quantity, then yes, that would be really amazing. But I just don't like that. Yeah, I like to have a very active kingdom, but I like challenge. You know, I like to have fights. Not you have 1,000 armies on the field and the opponents barely squeeze in an infantry march in that flag. And you have another 200 people trying to swarm a flag. I don't see fun in that. I mean, that's just me. That's just my opinion. You can look on my videos from previous Lost Kingdoms. And you will see that all my KVKs, they were all a struggle. They were all hardcore type of KVK. And I'm not talking just sitting there and watching a rally going. I'm saying from a field battle standpoint. Right? Not just sitting there and watching rallies going on and this. It was a struggle, you know, overcome the field battle and so on. Where's Solimar? I don't know, people keep saying he came back. I think he powered up to like 100 million again. Then probably stopped again, I don't know. King Talib migrated. Oh, finally migrated. COVID caught up to him and he decided to play rock more because there's nothing else to do. You never know. But why is none of them can squeeze in and come fight with me? Now everyone from my alliance is coming here and want to fight. I can't get a 1v1 fight. Let me just... How do you make that freaking... No. Okay, there. I'm rank 4 and I'm totally lost. Alright, let me just make a marker. And share it in the kingdom. I'm waiting your Saladin and Attila to fight. John, you're lost because of lack of sleep? What? What, Glocker? What? Alright, so now they come and gank me? Come on, just one. Why do you have to come all? Just one. Look at that, they all come out now. I just want to do a 1v1 march. Go, Rorona Miller. Come on, you're probably watching the stream. Come on the left side. Come on the left side. Oh my god, don't run away, please. Someone from 46, tell her to come on the left side. Do a 1v1 with me. Yes, you! Come here! Follow me. All right, they are all getting active now. All right, CJ bot is coming, but I bet that guy was gonna hit me too. Oh my goodness. Please save me. Only good trades. Of course. Why should even do 1v1? Alright, finally someone is fighting me. Alright, so we see Saladin and Attila against. Let's go Anu and Alex for sure. And 3, 4, 5, 7 more people coming in. Do you think you will ever be as powerful as Baba? No. I lose troops way too many to... Will I be able to get away? Let's see. I might be able to. Yeah. You're not smashing me. So that's their one versus one type of fighting. Well, they probably don't watch the live stream, so I don't blame them. I mean, in the end, we are in war, right? We are fighting over here for whoever is gonna win the Kingsland. Well, at least I put them on the move, so that's a good thing. Alright, let me see how bad that report was. Saladin and Attila. Alright, that was really bad. Saladin, he only had 210k, but I was warm. I don't think that counts so much. Yeah, Attila Takeda. Alright, so Saladin and Attila doesn't work. If I would have had Saladin and Takeda, this would have looked much better. Okay, who else can we try next? What else should we try next? That's the only way they will fight you. Lily should put a 1 versus 1 me text me for sure in the game. Can we see Saladin equipment? Oh yeah. It's full epic, all special talent. Sting, how are you doing, brother? Ahoy! Welcome to the stream. Try Edward and Ramses. What? Edward and Ramses? Ramses Tomiris. I did try Ramses Tomiris. It's too slow. I need something with march speed, because otherwise I won't get away. Can you try out Edward Alex, please? Edward Ramses. Alright, so I'm seeing Edward. I'm gonna do Edward next. Let me just equip my Edward and he's gonna be next, because since everyone wants to see Edward. Let's go Edward next. I'm gonna take from Constantine. Alright. Edward it is. Edward Alex, Edward Ramses. I'm gonna do Edward Alex. But I don't have the time tree to go with Alex. That's the problem. My time tree is for Tomiris. And I don't want to change it. So many. Alright, I'm going to change the talent. I'm going to change the talent and I'm going to try Edward. If that's what you all want to. Okay. Edward Alex, was it? I didn't change it. Switch. Confirm. Right, let's see. Edward. I'm gonna do Ramses as well, but let's do Edward Alex first. If that's what you want to see first. Let's see, where they gathering up? Or did they gather up? Oh no, they didn't left. Oh my god. I have to go up all the way again? Edward Alex, please. I'm doing Edward Alex and after that I'll try Edward Ramses. Just do Edward Ramses. Slow in skills cycle, but better than Edward Alex. Specific troop commanders, remember? I know Maverick, but in KvK, two people rally with Edward Alex. You didn't know that, right? You see? That's why. I'm a new player. Can you please tell me what's the best bundle in the super value bundles for speed ups? If you really care about speed ups, the first bundle that you want to buy is the coronation, the King's Coronation. And after that, it's the event bundles. That's the first bundles that you want to buy. King's Coronation and the event bundles give the highest amount of speed ups. Plus, with the event bundles, you'll also level up whatever event it is, and you just get more stuff. Like this one, in the Thanksgiving, you get more corn for your chicken. Best way to spend, if you are a high spender for KVK1, spend all on Living Legends. That's very true. Super Beta, what was that lol about? I'm coming also. I have you on the big screen now. Listen, Glocker, that's a good thing. If you're crashing and if you're lagging, at least you're gonna see where your march is, right? It's not that bad, after all. If the blind can fight, why not? How good is Alex? Alex Scipio, I haven't tried it, but Alex Julius Caesar is really great. Is Saladin very effective against Ramses? It's so and so. If you do one versus one, I think Ramses kind of tends to win, depends who you're gonna put Ramses with. I believe I've seen Ramses beating even Saladin Takeda. I've done some one versus one testing on my previous live stream, or the live stream before that. You can check, there is a playlist with one versus one testing. I put the live streams in those playlists. You'll find it over there. I'm not sure exactly which one is it, to be honest. But we did test that, and Ramses can beat even Saladin Takeda. Ramses with El Cid or something like that. Not to mention Attila Takeda. Ronnie for Cavalry made some test war helmet better than Abyssal. What do you think? I'm not sure what tests are you doing, to be honest, but when you group fight or when you swarm a target, defense doesn't really help you. That's why attack is the way to go. You do one versus one, then yes, health, defense, healing, that's what helps you. But when you go to war, when you do group fights and army fights, you need attack. Try charge Julius Caesar. Nah, you're not gonna see me trying that. Not in a million lives. Rage reduction of Khan. What rage reduction of Khan? Well, that's why Saladin Genghis works so well, because you pretty much have 900 rage. Can you give some recommendations on KVK2 rally and defense combos? On defense combos, Charles YSG is the most common, but I heard a lot of rumors. For example, Saladin being used in Garrison. I did use Saladin in Garrison in KVK3 or in KVK4. I'm not sure in which KVK. I use Saladin Takeda in Garrison, but I know Takeda is not available in KVK2. But you can do Saladin YSG, for example, or Saladin Minamoto. If you get hit with archers, you need to put calves and calf commanders, and they will help. As rally compositions is, again, cavalry in KVK2. Genghis Saladin, Saladin YSG, if they don't work, you have Edward for archers, Edward Alex. I heard that Edward Alex is working and it's breaking down the infantry pretty bad. Edward Tomiris, the most common Edward YSG. Alex YSG, Alex Charles Martel was also used a lot, but Alex YSG is the most common one. Saladin Alex, there's so many combinations that you can go with. Yeah, they're going back. Don't attack me. If the blind can fight, why not such a bright eye? Oh my Jesus Christ, I'm probably trying to do one versus one with that guy. Alright, so he's getting swarmed. Yeah, there's nothing you can do. They swarm me, no, my guys are swarming him. You can't do one versus one tests. People got adrenaline in their veins. Hold strong. Tsuki, okay, F in the chat. Yeah, I know, right? I think he wanted to do the one versus one, but I mean, what can you do? Look at that. My people just swarmed me. Well, I tried running, they swarmed me. I know. I mean, what can I do? I'm gonna try to go on the other side. If that guy follows me, I'm gonna hit him. I'm the one from India. I can't play the game anymore. Use a VPN. Pardon, thank you very much for your donation. Beard is gone. Yes, I woke up and I didn't recognize myself. I was looking in the mirror and I didn't recognize myself. And I was like, you know what? That's it. I chop it off. Yeah, Ronnie, you look different. I knew it. Yeah, I took off my beard. Alright, let's see if someone comes in. But no Saladins, come on. Edward Alex versus Saladin, no. Alright, CJ bot is coming again. Okay. That's it, we're gonna hide in the forest. CJ bot, come on over here. They're not gonna see us. The forest is gonna be our protection. I got wooden elves, so you should be very afraid, because you're gonna fight in a forest with wooden elves. Have you seen Lord of the Rings? Have you seen what Legolas can do? Well, all these archers are trained by Legolas. Be afraid, be very afraid. Where was it? Yes, keep it quiet, because otherwise people will see it. Farewell, Joan. Are you ready? I suppose you are. Before the others come around. No instant damage! Alright, who does he has? Oh, he has Edward and Tomiris. 10 turns, finally, 5,400, 7,800, again instant damage, and I'm getting swarmed again. Alright, that was probably the last one versus one try that I tried. It doesn't work. When people are in different kingdoms, it just doesn't work. 10,000 to 9,600. But I was swarmed a little. Yeah. I would say that I might have had a chance of winning. I think I would have won that. That's very interesting. Let's see on troops buff. And he has way higher stats than I do. I mean, I win on defense by 7, but he wins on health like 14%, and he wins on attack. That's because of Tomiris. Tomiris has like 30% archer attack, isn't it? Armed by this commander gain 30% increased attack. There you go. For the sun. But I think I would have won that. That's a 1 versus 1 fight. Counter attack damage has more by 4%. I have more? Normal attack damage? Crazy. Oh, skill damage 24%. How does the math work on this one? Alright, so 10. It beats me anyway. How is 24%? Alex's 4 skill state doesn't show in the reports. Yeah, I know it doesn't show in the reports. But like I said, I think I would have won that. Because I was swarmed and I had most heavily wounded. Yeah. Ronnie, please show us honor points rankings. Whoa. 757,000. I'm cap player. Do you think Saladin 5551 YSG max best garrison for me or Sun Tzu YSG? It depends on what type of rally you're gonna get. Sun Tzu YSG is good against anything that is not Attila Takeda. Or probably not even Chandra, William. As I heard, they are pretty devastating as well. It all depends what type of rally you got. If you get like a Guan Yu and something, or you know, the usual rally, Genki Saladin or whatever other else, Sun Tzu and YSG can do it. If you have the troops. So what was the second rally combo that we were supposed to try? Edward and Ramses? Let me see who I got equipment on. Got equipment on Edward, or I got equipment on Attila? No, I got on Guan Yu. Let me put something on Attila. Yeah, why not? And what else? Edward. Yeah, I can take the Edelfled. Get a couple more marchers over here so I can get more action going on. Get Attila and Takeda. And let's try something over here. Yeah, why not? Let's try Guan Yu YSG. Edward and Ramses would be better. Well, we'll find out. I'm gonna bring, once it gets home, I'm gonna bring Edward and Ramses. Atif Gohar, thank you very much. Guan Constantine. No, I'm not trying Guan Constantine. Can you show your Edward talent tree? It's with the full skill. This is my Edward talent tree. Two packs. Charles Julius Caesar is decent in field. I wouldn't try them, to be honest. You have no damage, just tank. Even if you bring a Joan second to the Charles, is way more beneficial than having a Charles and Julius Caesar on the field. What works in Sunset Canyon doesn't mean all the time that it's also working on the battlefield. Oh, Ramses is first. He's the King of Kings. And he's leaded by Edward. The King of Kings is leaded by Edward. Ronnie, come middle of ruins. Alright, oh, so you wanna try against Ramses as well, alright. Well, there is someone there. There is Theo. Alright, he's going away. I'm gonna bring Edward and Ramses this time. See how that goes. I'm not very hyped about Edward and Ramses because you pretty much want more skills from Ramses rather than just having slow skills. Just to offer more defensive option for Edward. We'll see how that goes. But I think faster skill damage or more skill damage might have worked better. When are you going to max Artemisia after this Mightiest Governor? Sunday. Sunday I'm gonna max her. When Nebu and Cyrus come to Rock, I suppose after next Mightiest Governor. I think they want to do another 6 Mightiest Governor cycles on the older kingdoms to bring more and more kingdoms on the same page with commanders. So instead of keep introducing new commanders every 2 months, right, because they introduce Lubu and they keep adding some of these commanders here and there, they might just add every 3 months the other new commanders. Which is quite alright. Can you show Saladin 3? Yeah, we can show Saladin 3. There you have it, Saladin 3. 3, 2, 1, go. Where are you in event? Are you talking about my chicken? You wanna see my fluffy chicken? Oh no, I was so close. 8 more. Why? I'm gonna unlock it when I reach 25. I do this every time because when you unlock it all the way, you just get everything. All of that, you know, it looks a lot. So I usually just get to the 25, then I press unlock. It's a lot of juicy stuff that you get. Race against time. I'm still first. Check PM in game. I don't read PMs in games during live streams. I'm seriously gonna kick people from the alliance because I'm rank 4 if you guys not gonna let me do 1v1 with this guy. I'm just gonna put it in the alliance. Savage Ronnie. Now I'm serious, gonna get upset. I mean, I wanna do my battles, right? They can go there on the left side and go fight and bang your head. Look at that. There's plenty of people. Go fight in the front of their gate. Look at that. Just go there and fight. Just don't mind me. Let's go in the forest, because the forest works for me. My wooden elves. Yes, nobody's gonna see us here. That's it. This is the perfect spot. So I'm still getting way more normal damage. I just don't get it. Alright, so I done the first skill, 7,900. He done 7,500. Hmm. 7,200. 3,500. That's pretty equal in damage. Yeah, I went first on yellow. Yeah, he's winning. The debuffs is real. See, Edward Tomiris. He also dominates mean stats. Which makes a difference. Or wait, am I going to win this? No, I don't think so. I got first on yellow, I'm gonna be first on red. Yeah, so I was the first to shrink as well on my march. Means I lost the more troops. There is two things that you need to know about this. We don't have the circle with 3% all damage, which I think they do, and we don't have a high rune with 5% attack. So I think they have way. Oh no, hold on, this is AK. I think AK don't have it yet. There's nothing to fight, Glocker. By the way, Glocker, thank you very much for the donation, brother. I read it, but I forgot to mention it. For the no lag device. I hope that's gonna be true. Alright, so what's the situation over here? How is it going on? Basically, what Tomiris does just cancels Ramzes' skill damage reduction. So if I would have had a Tomiris, or maybe a YSG, might have been a little bit better. Or not YSG, because that would be too devastating. I don't know. It looks so equal. I mean, look at that. Ramzes is a third generation Archer, right? And Tomiris is a second generation Archer. And we're just using the primary, which... The primary is the difference. And I do have to say, I got heal from Ramzes. I do get heal from Ramzes. Might have then been the difference. It looks like I'm winning now. That's my apologies. That's crazy. So he was winning at the beginning when he had more troops. And then on lesser troops, I'm doing better. How does that work? How does that work? It's a huge enigma. Really huge enigma. How he was winning at the beginning and now I'm winning towards the end. I'm not gonna win by a whole lot, but hey. I don't know, 20,000 troops. Yeah, 20,000 troops. It's the magic of the game, Flesh. Yeah, it can be. 2,000 difference on severely wounded. And I had 7,000 heal, which you can't really compare. It is a whole lot heal. Because I was the first one to go on yellow. Troops buff, 24% skill damage. I don't know how that's working. And he has 18%. In stats, he won by a lot. He has 30% from Artemisia, and that's another 12 extra. I'm guessing buffs, maybe he has a 10% buff, not a 5%. So that can be another 5%, then the high rune, because we don't have the 5% attack high rune. So that's 10%. Yeah, we're getting there. Then health and archer defense, I won. A little bit. That's because of the equipment. So probably the equipment difference. Interesting, but I won. Max, that's Richard, not in a thousand lifetimes. Ronnie, I think gonna be more Dynasty Warriors. Look on the 9 card. When right Dynasty Warriors. I heard as well that they plan to do... How is the best way to say it? So what they plan to do with the Dynasty Warrior thingy, like about when they added Lubu and Diao-chan, this is gonna be regular, like every 9 weeks or every 8 weeks, they're gonna introduce more Dynasty Warrior commanders. So probably this is more like a year contract they might just have with them, so we might just see regular commanders, including epics, which is not bad at all, right? I'm gonna go with... hold on, not all of them. I'm gonna take Guan Yu and YSG next. I wanna see how bad or good it is. Isn't skill damage from the city skin you have? Yeah, but that's 6. 24 to 18 difference. That's 6. And my city skin is 5. I think Edward YSG or Edward Cyrus is good. Yeah. Edward YSG definitely is really good. Alright, so you're saying when I click on this one, it doesn't do anything. Watch my dance closely. I would definitely, especially in private. You're probably referring from over here. The powerful demon god. It doesn't do anything. What are you telling me to click on? If there must be OP commanders, it should be Lubu. I'm so disappointed. He sucks. He's good only for debuff. Yep, and the problem is, when you debuff, you shouldn't be a second in command. And that's where you have to use him. You have to use him as second in command. Where was my friend over here? Can you bring Guan and Alex? See if I can win with Guan YSG. Hold on, let me change my city design. Let me use my Babylonian Garden, because I trained 2 million T5s? Oh, no. I won it with 17 million points. That's 1.7 million T5s. Yes, I trained 1.7 million T5s for Babylonian Garden. And the only time I use this is when I do 1v1 tests. How about that? Isn't that awesome? 1.7 million T5s and I only test with this design. I keep the 5% skill all the time. Alright, what's the situation over here? Holyfield got his Richards. Alright, when people bring their Richards, it's so funny. Let me try to squeeze in with my Guan Yu somewhere over here. When's the last patch of Lubu go? I think gonna come another combo of Dynasty Warriors. I believe as well, maybe not right after it, maybe on a week or two later. But yeah, I did heard about that. That we plan to introduce regular Dynasty Warrior 9 commanders. Diao-chan looks so sadistic. Listen, she's really amazing as an epic. After I tested her in the ruins and I've done a couple of tests with Diao-chan, I said that if I didn't have that many legendaries, it's exactly like I mentioned in the video, I would have put her in my army. If this would have been like a KVK1 or KVK2 situation, when I had to use Belisarius and God knows what commanders, I would have definitely put Diao-chan instead. I would definitely replace and rearrange my marchers for the field and make sure I'm gonna put Diao-chan in there. Surav Pramod, thank you very much for becoming a member to the channel. Welcome to Legends Army. Thank you very much for your support. Hello from 2079. Hello. Shout out to 916. Civilizations you want to be added. Honestly, I'm not so much about which civilizations they want to add or how many civilizations they want to add. I would be more interested in different stats. That's why I change civilization, not because how they look or what special units they have. That's a little of interest for me. What I care about civilizations is the bonuses they carry. Because I've tested and I've done my tests, and for example Byzantium, which is supposed to be the most defensive cavs, it's very little noticeable. Right, they even give cavs health and the stats on the cataphracts. They are very defensive, a lot of defense, a lot of health, and not so much attack. It just doesn't, it's, what's on the paper just doesn't show on the actual reports. So what I want to see is just different, more stats, better stats, civilizations. That's what I want to see. Like Spain, for example. I really like the Conquistadors, cav defense. So if they would introduce a civilization with cavs that have the stats of the Conquistadors, but probably different stats over here, like resource production and experience, for me, this is not being so great anymore. The resource gathering, the experience, or yeah, the experience gained from barbarians and auto neutral units is just the cav defense and the cav themselves. But for example, when you go to Arabia, I am a rally leader, so I get 5% cav attack, I get the special memlocks, and then the damage dealt, no, where is it? Damage dealt to barbarians and all the neutral units. And I believe when it says all the neutral units, it also has effect when you rally barbarian objectives like passes, like high runes, circles, and whatever other objective it is. Or probably even when you're fighting Ceroli, those should be neutral units as well. So a lot of benefits I can get myself for from Arabia. On the other hand, if I would have to field battle, like only field battle and not rally, I would be Spain for sure. I was Spain in the past and I was very happy with the results. But for rally purposes, just Arabia is better. Because that's what I want. I want attack and I want more damage with the rally. That just works perfect. One minute and 15 seconds. Oh, he's going back. Hold, wait, stop. No, come back. Where is it? Do we have a comeback? We need control, we need DPS. Cover our allies. No, that was the wrong title. Well, they are fighting anyway. Feather, hey, do you think they should introduce new tier of troops between tier 4 tier 5? No, I don't think they should introduce. The more tiers they would introduce, the more complicated it's going to get. Hey, Ronnie, I'm free to play and I have Max Khan, YSG, and 5551 Saladin. Should I work on Takeda or Alex? The way I see it, you're pretty much cav oriented. But Alex can give you way more utilities overall, Suvik. I would say that you will not regret working on Alex. And after that, Takeda. Alfather, you're getting your ass kicked. You're getting your ass kicked by Saladin. Saladin Genghis. Who is coming over there? Sidrip. Okay, hold on. He has Guan Yu and Alex. Okay, that's good. So let's try Guan Yu and Alex versus Guan YG. I think I'm gonna get my ass whooped. No, no, Atlantis, don't retreat. Retreat, Atlantis. I'm gonna demolish you. Better run away. All right, so in terms of damage, he's doing way more damage. Don't get, I'm doing AoE. Right, I've done 6,000 and 6,000, but he done the additional damage. So it's RNG, a lot of RNG is involved as well. Yeah, I think I'm losing. My health bar went lower. He also has Legionnaires. You see the additional damage? He got the additional damage and I didn't. Look, he done it again plus Alex. Oh no, hold on. He went first on yellow. That did he had? I think he had 260. Who did I scout it first? Am I going to beat Guan Yu and Alex with Guan Yu YSG? How did he do more damage? I have the freaking YSG with 50% skill damage. How did he do 4,800? Look, 5,000? How did that happen? I don't get it. Are those mine out? No, I don't think so. Look, I hit that guy. No. Kill steal. People are staying in the AoE, so I do less damage? No. Looks pretty equal, or I don't know what's happening. Am I winning by a margin? I think so. And I still don't get it. Why? Because he was doing so good at the beginning and he's doing so high numbers. Like, I've even seen like 5,000. I haven't done those numbers. But like Flay said, you know, the magic of the game. Mina Diao Chan better than Mina 5533 double C? No, a thief, Mina double C is still better. If you have legendaries and high skill legendaries, use them. Is there another Alex over there? No, that's Glocker. With Attila Takeda. If there would have been another Alex, then yeah, it would have interfered with the test. I think, alright, so now it's coming back. I believe it's the amount of rage. Because I have YSG and I have the full feral nature. So I'm definitely generating way more rage than he does. So that was the whole deal, I'm guessing. I'm also expecting that I might have more severely wounded. Which sounds crazy, I'm winning, but I'm also expecting that I'll have more. Let's see. Because he had the shields. Ha! Someone wants easy kills. Get on him. Get on him. He doesn't get any easy kills. That's it. Alright, let's see. No, he had most severely wounded. By 3,000. I won by 7,000. Alright, let's see on the troops buff. Who did I hit? Extra severely wounded. Let's see on the troops buff. Oh, wow. I had more troop stats than him. Oh, no. Except health. He had 2% more health. Attack. Oh wow, I 24% more attack. That's a lot. And on defense, we were equal on defense. But yeah, on attack, I had way more. I don't have a 10% skin with 10% attack. And I only have a 5% buff. I guess he went more defensive. I'm guessing that's why he also has more health than me. I'm like this guy, Saladin 5551 and YSG Khan Max Alex. I'm thinking to go for Attila Takeda because it's the best match on ruins. And in KvK, you fight a lot for ruins. After that, Guan Alex. You know, that's not a bad choice to go for. If you have a lot of Cav commanders already done, then yeah, you want to go for Takeda. And you want to get Attila done as well. Alex Shields. I didn't check. Oh, his gun is max or what? No, he's max. Oh, he's max. Come on. I thought he's not max. He's max. He's probably not VIP 17. I didn't ask that. Because, yeah, VIP 17 can have an important role. Let me see. Can I tell from the troops buff? He might not be VIP 17. 7% skill damage. He's not. He's not VIP 17. But I can tell you that by his normal attack and counter attack damage. You see, I have 9.5 and 9.5. And 5% is from the VIP 17. Which he doesn't have. Yeah, he's not VIP 17. Can you try Khan YSG? I'm not sure against what I can try Khan YSG, to be honest. My Artemisia is not max yet. I would love to try it. My YSG Khan Richard is 5511. I want to get more kills from Ruins Altars. Should I go for Attila Takeda? I'm free to play. Logic boys, Attila Takeda is a very good option, but I'll be very honest, if you also don't have equipment, if you also don't max them, it's not going to be easy to get more kills. If you want to just get more kills, you need to be to play more careful. We got players in the Alliance that are 25 million power, and they get kills in the ruins because they play very careful. You know, you don't just go in the middle of the murder ball and hope to get kills. Even with Khan and YSG, or even with Richard and YSG, you can get killed. You just can't expect to keep going in the middle and wonders will happen. You need to play careful sometimes. I mean, hit targets, obviously, you will get in the murder ball. You can't avoid it, but just don't be in the middle, and especially when you get target. That's why playing with sounds helps so much, because you hear when you get targeted, and every time you get a new target on you, you keep hearing the sounds. It makes a very funny sound when you keep getting targeted. And that way you can tell, and you can play with any march, but you need to hear that. You won't know if you don't play with sound. That's what I do. I hear when I get targeted, and I immediately know which march is it, because I see the health bar and I see the march flickering. You can see that as well. This is things that you notice by battling a lot. There you go. I just spilled some very secrets of the secrets that even the secrets themselves, they would secret them and they would probably snipe me right now from the window. How about that? A lot of tips and tricks. Hey Ronnie, have you tried Harald Teo? In about 6 months, when they come into my kingdom, I might give it a try. You never know. In 6 months' time, a lot of things can happen. Can you show us your Guan Yu gear? Yeah, I can show you my Guan Yu gear. Let me press the help. Let's see, Guan Yu gear. That's what I had on my Guan Yu. I still need this one with special talents. I'm delaying this so much. And Frost Reds, another 2 defense. That would help a lot. Which lineage? That would be another 2.5 attack. That would be great. So you wanted me to try Genghis and YSG? Hope against not Attila. I would not go with Genghis and YSG against Attila. God, no. Let me think. What else can we try? Someone said Edward and El Cid. Oh man, I crafted on last week 3 epic equipment, 4 infantry and 0 crits. I was so mad. You should try to forge some of the white ones. White ones, green ones before you go with the epic. And if you don't get 2-3 crits, 4 crits of white or green, then you can go for an epic. And if that epic didn't win with special talent, then you can try another epic and another epic. That's kind of the highest chances that you can have. Genghis Saladin, that's not a bad option. Let me just change back the city design. Hey, Babylonian Garden worked. It just gave me a win. How the counterattack damage works? Can you please explain? You watch the battle log. That's the easiest way I can explain. Is the attack, and then there is counterattack follow up. That's how it works. The way to play with Genghis in the ruins or anywhere else on the battlefield, you need to play with him very careful. So, for example, when I'm gonna go in Kingsland, I'm gonna do Genghis and Takeda. Alright, let me just put the equipment and I'm gonna get Genghis out there. Heart of the Saint. I'm gonna get Saladin naked. He has his sands to protect him. That's fine. Cloud Racers. Ooh. Well, you know what? I'm not sure it even works though. Alright. Best equipment ever. Let's go out. Genghis and Saladin. Let's see what this mofo can do. Ramses Tomiris, please. I tried Ramses Tomiris. Genghis Takeda. Yes, that's gonna be my plan for Kingsland. You're gonna see plenty of Genghis Takeda once Kingsland open. Do you ever done test about T5 versus mixed T4, T5 just to low down the hospital costs? Marcos Campione. About the lowering down the hospital cost, I've tried that. I've tried that in KVK3 and I've tried that in KVK4. Which it was live versus, no, one of them was the old map and one of them was live versus darkness. All I can say about that is that you might save up on resources, but you're still gonna kill your speed ups. Because T4 are cheaper to heal, but you need a whole lot more speed ups. So if you do have speed ups, but you don't have resources, then yeah, T4 are very useful. But when you have resources, like in billions, it's much better to just go T5s. They have higher value. But like, you know, free to play or how a lot of people play with a lot of T4 and they try to do as much free healing as possible. Yeah. Definitely T4. Or if you have a lot of speed ups and low resources. The advantages of tier 4 is that you can keep field battle presence at low costs. So when you're low on resources, when you really get low, even myself, which sounds crazy, but I can do T4 and I can continue fighting because I have speed ups. So I can still have a field battle presence because I have very good commanders and equipment and all that. And even T4 would be powerful. I will spend a lot of speed ups on hospital, like I already mentioned probably twice, but I can still have a field battle presence. That's why when you look at my troops, I have a lot of tier 4. They are designed to die, you know, originally. That's kind of their design. But if things go sideways and I spent all my resources, then I can go with tier 4. I'm probably not going to kill so many infantry to not have at least a march of infantry, or a march of archers, and 2-3 marches of cavs. You know, I'm still going to have that. And I'll probably just start killing tier 5s and then start using tier 4 on the battlefield because I'm low on resources. So there's a lot of options that you can do when you have different types of troops. You know, there's a lot of strategies that you can do. When you have only one type of troops, you're limited at what you can do. You can only use those troops to field fights, you can only use those troops to join rallies, and so on. Please do Saladin William. I don't have William. We're gonna get William in about a month, I guess. I'm talking about 40-60 or 30-70 T4, not a full T4 march. Yes, Marcos, that's what I have tried in KVK 3 and 4. I was using a 100k tier 4, no, 100k tier 5 and 200k tier 4. That's what I was doing, to try to increase the value. It does increase the value of the march, but you still get a lot of tier 4 in hospitals. And it's weird because sometimes you get a lot of tier 5 in hospital and you only have 100k. It depends how heavily you're swarmed, which is hard to explain. But I just didn't find it very efficient. Yeah, tier 4 does have a value. I think there even is someone with 6 billion tier 4 calves in his city. Crazy. 6 billion flesh? I think you want to say 6 million. 6 billion is too much. You would have more power than a kingdom altogether. 6 billion tier 4. 6 billion tier 4, there will be 24 billion power. There's no alliance that has that much power. Try Genghis Takeda in ruins. Well, I have Genghis and Saladin out. I'm gonna try Genghis Takeda next. Let's see if I can get some fights. Let's be friendly. Hello. Let's see if we can get the 1v1. Your notes. Do you try to put Alex with Attila, Saladin, Khan? I did try. I think in KVK3 or KVK4, it didn't work so well. Saladin, Alex, it works. Genghis, Alex works. But with Attila, I only found double C to be worth it. I've tried Aetherfled, I've tried plethora of combinations. Maybe Joan of Arc would be interested to try with Attila, which sounds really crazy, right? How would you put Joan of Arc? I don't think they... Let's see. Oh no, I don't want to go against Attila Takeda. It's just a lot of civilly wounded. Saladin Takeda? No, Saladin Takeda also demolishes Genghis Saladin. So what do we have here? Rorona Miller. Oh no, she wants to go for me. Help? Is there a help emoji? Let's see. Help? Yeah, there is. If you want one versus one, at least control your people. They're not my people. At least control your people. What's that supposed to mean? I already text them, I already wrote them in the chat. Genghis with William, tried the best. We don't have William in this kingdom. William 5551 is good as secondary in your opinion? Yes, you can check the William Commander spotlight. I'm all over William. But 5551 is really amazing. Flash just killed me. 62k severely wounded troops. Oh my god, Edis and Dina. Edionis, Dina, my apologies. He used his Atila Takeda. Make blue stacks full screen. It's not full screen? Hold on. No, it's full screen. Well, if I make it full screen, I won't be able to read the chat. I don't have a second monitor. Is Attila Takeda the best field combo? In Ruins, it works really great. I wouldn't say that it's the best field combo. It's hard to classify the best field combo. But in Ruins, it's very good on trades. Like severely wounded wise. But I have only tier 4. Well, then bring 2 marches or 1.5 more. I don't know what to say. Yeah, that's why we don't get any 1 versus 1. Oh, hold on. I have Soda over here. Ha! But why is he in hot? He should be in K. Genghis and why is G? Why my Genghis is out? I could try Alex and YSG, but no, that's infantry versus Cavs. It's not gonna work. So how, what should I try against the Genghis and YSG? Legend Ronnie, you think Attila 5111 is good to go for Ruins? I paired with Takeda, of course. If Takeda is max, yes. That's the sausage. Attila 5-1-1 is already good to go for Ruins. Just don't expect if you go on Richards and Guan Yu's to be so offensive. But if you go on Archers and Weak Marchers, Double C's, Genghis, you will get very good trades. How about going with Ramses and Diao Chan against Genghis and YSG? Yes, I win. I was in blue team. I beat the red team. It's good for you. Try Attila John. Attila John? That can work. Soda, I'm gonna hit you with Attila. What a coupon do I? Alright, that's pretty equal. That's pretty good. I do have some skill damage reduction on Attila. He might demolish me though. I might win on Severely Wounded, but I think he might demolish me. Guan is good in 5-1-1. Guan is good in 5-1-1-1. You need 1st, 3rd, and 4th of Guan Yu. Attila Alex? Well, we can try anything with Attila, right? Attila Alex. Listen, let's try Attila John first. I'm really curious. Attila John. He's gonna demolish me with skill damage. I have no doubt in that. Wicked Truth. Hey, Ronnie. Long time no chat. Hope you and your family are well. Hey, thank you very much. Yes, everything is well. Alright, let me wake him up. Hold on, wait. I think he had 210,000. Yeah. Oh, damn it. Let me get 210,000. Yeah, that's it. Mr. Smoke Turkey, thank you very much. Okay, Alex and John. What does Glocker has there? 310. Holy smokes. You want me to... This is the boss. I'm gonna use 5 marchers. I'm gonna swarm with Ramses and YSG. He's on my territory. I'm gonna get territorial bonuses if I fight him. What does he expect? How is this looking over here? Yeah, people are still all over there. Yeah, nothing happening. Ramses YSG or Ramses El Cid? I think Glocker is waiting to get in K, I'm supposed. Wakey wakey, is there a text? Wakey wakey. Protect the rally. We need control. What's that supposed to mean? We need control. Forward march. Why nobody uses Charlemagne? Well, that's a secret. I can't tell you. I would really want to tell you, but I just don't. You know what? Only people that max Charlemagne can tell you why they don't use it. He's so OP that they just don't use it. He's the King of Hearts. Did you know that? Hey, Ronnie. HBK is here. How you doing, mate? I'm doing fine. Hey, welcome to the stream. Would you buy a 500 billion from each kind of resources with just $4,000? $500 billion? Well, bro, compared to the bundles in the game, I mean, that's some godlike prices. 500 billion. My god. Will you max Charlemagne and Lubu and solo his cities? If I max Charlemagne and Lubu, I can zero Glocker. But I don't want a zero Glocker, and I'm not gonna max Charlemagne and Lubu. Oh my god, so now Soda woke up. So Glocker has Saladin YSG, but you're gonna demolish me Glocker with Saladin and with Ramses and YSG. It's normal skill versus skill damage. Okay, listen, I'm gonna try Soda first, because I have 210k. Let's see how this one works. So it's normal attack damage, I'm demolishing him, but wait for the skill damage. 4,800. This is an interesting combo, yo. And I'm losing. I was clicking on the help button. I know. I just don't see it. Yeah, I'm losing, definitely. Genghis YSG, I mean, come on, it's a lot of skill damage. But I might win severely wounded wise. I guess. Because he's doing next to zero normal attack, and I'm doing a lot of normal attack. He's winning on the skill damage, though. You already tried Saladin Attila? Yes, Christian. But it wasn't one versus one, it was group fights. Whoa! Genghis Saladin would be a good test against Ramses, YSG. Let me see. Or I'm gonna retrieve my Genghis and fight with the Glocker. Yeah, I'm just gonna get my Genghis over here and fight with Glocker. Yeah, look at that. I'm getting demolished. I paid $4,000 for 1 trillion kind of resources. Well, you know, I don't think it's legal to buy resources in the game, so make sure nobody knows your account name and all that if you've done that. Muhammad. Attila John of Ark. What the fuck? Alright. Hmm? Told you so. Told you I'm gonna win on Severely Wounded. Look at that, normal attack, 46%. Counterattack damage, 46%. He had more calf health than me? That's crazy. You see, I got demolished, but you had Attila on the field, which is powerful, is tanky, is defensive, causes a lot of severely wounded, and you had Joan of Arc as well, buffing your allies. Attila and John. Yujiro, I would say put at least one more skills in that double C, and after that you can use it. 3-5-5-5, yeah. But 2-5-5, no. Alright, let me just, you said double C. Yeah, once you reach 1000 damage factor, you can use him. At least 3-5-5-5, you'll have 30% attack, you'll have heal, rage, and at least 1000 damage factor. So that's alright. One more skills and we can use it. So I'm getting my Genghis and I'm gonna go hit Glocker. Hey, those free to play with Max Can. Do you feel he is worth it? Why not? Why wouldn't he worth it? If you have a Max Genghis and a Max YSG, that doesn't mean you have to fight Attilas and Takedas, bro. It doesn't mean you have to go inside the murder ball and just get demolished by 100 people. If you have a Genghis and YSG, you need to know how to pick your targets. Fight with the murder ball, but play smart. Genghis and YSG can do wonders. If you play them well. Dorzona, hey, welcome. What about Saladin Takeda? Well, Saladin Takeda is a beast. Too defensive. Let's get over here. Attila, Julius Caesar, why not? Yeah, but like I said with John, at least you're buffing your allies. You can try that Attila Joan on Ramses YSG. No, 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 thank you. I won't try that. Saladin Takeda does no damage. Oh, they do damage. They cause a lot of severely wounded. They don't do much skill damage or much visible skill damage, but... Who is better to expertise? Attila or William? I have Takeda expertise already. It depends what you want, Ronald. If you want to cause a lot of severely wounded in ruins, easy way, then you want Attila. But I'll be more inclined of doing William as utilities before Attila. If you're not rallying just for ruins, it's entirely up to you. But if you have both of them and you want to choose, you might want to look a little bit into William. It's much helpful. KVK wise, alliance wise, arc wise. Attila is just very unique on rallying. Is the meta, doesn't matter if Theodora is Zenobia, is whatever it is. In KVK is the meta because it cannot be swarmed. And once you control the field, then you can pretty much take flags with whatever. So it's the meta in rallying, in KVK, and in ruins on causing severely wounded. All right, let's go ahead. Let's see Genghis and Saadin versus Ramses and YSG. Let's see how powerful is his Ramses and YSG against my Genghis and Saladin. Come get some. Oh, Glocker is not looking so good. Glocker is gonna feel pale soon. Hold on. Am I losing against archers? I might be. I might be losing against archers. Hey Ronnie, try Takeda in double C. My Takeda is not 60 and will never be 60. Not forever, not anytime soon. Attila Takeda has no value in team battles. Almost no value, almost. If you have the numbers, it's much better to bring marshals that gives value to the murder ball. But if you don't have the numbers, Attila Takeda is kind of the way to go. If you have the numbers, you need AoE, you need buffs, you need all those kind of stuff. Why YSG circle is yellow? Because he's in a different alliance. It's letting me know that he's not friendly. That's why he's yellow. YSG Frederick. No, Illy. So I'm gonna get my ass kicked by Ramses. The problem with Genghis is when you get under 50% or under 70%, in an actual battle, you don't leave your Genghis to die. Because you know Genghis has less skill damage, between 70 and 50%, right? Yeah, 70 and 50%. So that 20%, that's when you lose value on Genghis, and that's when Ramses gained value. Because Ramses and YSG, they don't have any. How are they called? I said it in my last video. They don't have any conditional damage increase or decrease, but Genghis has. And I have the best gear on my Genghis. But hey, you wanna bring a Ramses YSG on a murder ball when I have 5 marches? I'm gonna wish you good luck with that. Check Kindle report I posted. Alright, so Glocker is showing a Kindle report. Oh, that was a... Oh, wow. Attila Takeda against Saad in Genghis. Oh, gotcha. Oof, 93,000. That's a lot. Let's see how much I got. Defeat 35,000 versus 32,000. Troops buff. Skill damage 22%. I don't know how that works. It blows my mind, to be honest. 22%. Did we got the circle with 3%? Maybe that way I can do some math. I'll have to look. He has 68% skill damage. Grab a beer. Hey, I'm alright. Thank you very much. Ronnie, try Saladin Mina. Saladin first? I think I can do more damage with Genghis first. If I put Saladin first, I don't think I will do better against Ramses. Archer attack, defense, and health. 177 defense on archers. He almost has more defense than attack. How is that possible? If he's gonna put El Cid, he's gonna have 200 defense? That's crazy. Well, I'm not very far in defense either. I have 190, so... Health? Yeah, pretty equal. What? No, I don't want to email him. I'll tell him straight in his face. Oh my god, there's 4 minutes left of the room. How lucky I was. I just remembered it. Feral nature is a waste of talent on any commanders, and the rune that gives you 9 rage per attack is one of the worst talents. Peter Jankovic. Well, that's your opinion, my friend. Oh, Shizzle Majnizzle. That's why he beat me. I forgot about it. This was my event talent tree. Glocker, we have to do this again. This is my PvE talent tree. When I've done Lohar arms training, because I don't use him in field battles, and I said, you know what, I'm just gonna switch back. Yeah, look at that. No emblazoned shield. Naked rage. I mean, of course he beat me. So I was really wondering, how the hell did he beat me? Yeah, I had this talent tree. I mean, it's not rocket science why I lost. All right, let me switch the talent trees and we do this again. A good thing I didn't fought on. I remembered. I think this is the one I use on the field. Yeah, this is my talent tree. All right, we have to go again. Right, 260. The Revenge of Genghis. Let's see, if I win, then it was the talent tree. Samuel Rivera, hi Ronnie. Thank you very much for your donation. Is primary or secondary with who? William, primary or secondary with who? I would recommend William to be a secondary. Secondary with who? I would say that with Saladin. That's also my plan. But if you have Chandra, I hope I'm not on territory. I hope that doesn't count. I think I'm way off. I don't think it counts. I think it's doing way less kill damage, right? I think so too. All right, so Samuel Rivera, to answer your question. If you want to use William primary, I believe that with Takeda as a second in command, it's kind of the best way it can work. A lot of players try different combinations, but I would prefer William as a second in command because you want to hide him. He doesn't have any defense and you want to keep him on the battlefield for as long as possible. Did I switch my talents? Or I didn't. Oh yeah, it switched. So doesn't blindness on a shield doesn't work at all? What the hell? It doesn't count. Your target need to be on the alliance territory. Oh, you gotcha. I think I'm losing even worse. That's insane. Saladin Max Takeda is better. It does. You're still losing. Yeah, and I think I'm losing even worse. Poor Genghis Khan. Ronnie, go on us primary with my Alex. Is it enough for Guan to be 5-1-1-1 tanks? Todor, yes, it is good enough to start using him for field battles. City skin? Yeah, I have the right city skin. I have the 5% skill. Show the race against time rank. I'm rank 2 with 190k points in Kingdom map. This time I'm losing worse because I've done. It doesn't explain anything. So it means that more nuking power helps more, or was it a 20% attack reduction from the previous talent? That's crazy. I mean, this should be more defensive talent tree. 12% skill damage. It means that Emblazoned Shield is shit. This is my resume from this battle. Look, this is even worse. That's insane. Well, 1,000 and something more severely wounded. He still got 32,000. And he was left with more troops. So isn't Blunderzen and Shield that bad? It's better to go with Naked Rage and all that nuking firepower. Doesn't make any sense to me. It really doesn't. This game is an enigma of how things work in this game, to be honest. I've beat Ramses before like that. 9 rage per attack, you need 100 to get one extra skill. And you need to attack constantly, it's just a bad talent. I would rather have a couple of stats. YG has 10% trigger chance, can just be RNG. That's very true. That's very true. Because if you get the 100 Usher attack at the time when Ramses or YSG they do their skill, then that's a way more powerful skill. Especially at the beginning when you have a fresh march. That's also true. RNG does play an important role. Best secondary for Genghis Khan. Saladin or Takeda? One of the two. Maybe he has better equipment than you. Well, what more better equipment than this you want on your Genghis? What more better than this you want? Silent Trial? Full special talent except the pendant. Everything else is full special talent. Well, Genghis is also RNG based, that's very true, again. A lot of variables. You have the chosen one. If this one procs at the beginning when you have full mark, that can be a lot of damage right at the beginning. Best secondary for Pelagius, double C. Kao Kao. Chocolate. The chocolate guy. The conqueror of chaos. The conqueror of chocolate kingdom. William is with Genghis, the best. Just bring it on the field on my 5 marches. Meet for the grinder. What do we have over there? Genghis and Takeda. Alright, Genghis and Takeda. Should I try Genghis and Saladin against Genghis and Takeda? I mean, what else would be better? Bring Attila in double C again? Nah. No. Attila in double C? Yeah, that's a... Where is my Attila? Double C or Richard? If you're infantry player Richard, if you're Cav, then... Should I bring double Attila in double C against Genghis and... Takeda, what do you all think? I know 210k. If I try Saladin double C, I need to Attila double C. Yes, do it. Genghis Khan Takeda. Now let's try something different. The usual marches, we keep trying that all the time. Respect double C. Attila Takeda still OP? Still very good, yeah. Oh, he has LCD and Ramses. Alright, let's go. Attila double C against Genghis and Takeda. Oh boy, 4000 damage. 2000 damage only? Oh. I don't think this will work. I think I'm getting squashed. Yep. Definitely. It's too much skill damage. Especially that Takeda gives 40% attack. It helps Genghis a lot. Oh yeah, I'm getting demolished. And I get 10% defense reduction by double C. No, this was a bad test. Alright, let's see if really wounded wise. That's also what I'm interested in. So I did use Attila double C in KVK 3 or no, in KVK 4. I used Attila double C and I was quite alright with the results. Alright, that's it. Alright, let's see the report. I still had more severely wounded than he did. Yeah. Very interesting. Wow, 14,000 heal? That's a lot of healing. I barely done 4,000. Didn't work. So as much attack as I had on my calves, let's see, 282 cav attack. I don't think the double C expertise shows up. Cavalry units led by this commander gain 25% increased attack at the expense of 10% reduction defense. Yeah, I don't think they show in the troops buff. I should have had way over 300 cav attack with double C. Anyway. Kakashi, you have max YSG, but your Richard is 5120, level 30. So I can't chain with that pair in KVK. Do you have any other suggestions to chain up to 10 bars with YSG, a secondary? Put YSG first, use YSG first and Richard second. And go with archers, and you'll be able to chain bars. What do we have here? What other crazy combos should we try? Alcide and Ramses. Ghost Adin and Takeda. Against Alcide and Ramses? But I don't have the correct talents for Saladin. I don't have the talents for Takeda. Attila Julius Caesar. No, I'm not doing Attila Julius Caesar. I've done testing with Attila. El Cid! El Cid with Frederick. Can you replace John with Ilium? With William? Well, you should bring both if it's possible, but yeah. If you don't bring John, then bring William. At least you'll have damage with William. Let me think. No, it's not good. I was thinking to bring Alex. Well, it's kind of bad equipment on Alex. Not so great. I was thinking to bring Alex and Julius Caesar. But I don't think that will work. Ramses and Frederick? I could try Ramses and Tomiris. See if El Cid or Tomiris is better second to Ramses. Ramses and Alex. Well, Alex has plenty of utilities. We should try to exclude commanders that have so many utilities. Ramses and Frederick. Why would you want to try Frederick with Ramses? Let's give it a try, Ramses and Frederick. People are keep going on about Frederick. It's not like Frederick is a priority to Max. You know, is trying to go more about commanders that people would, you know, also Max. Like, it will be helpful to Max. Nobody cares to Max Frederick. But listen, let's try it. We're gonna try it. Elmac, should I focus on Richard 554 to level 50? Can't level 60 do it to start? Or use Sun to level 60, Richard second? Elmac, if you are out of options, then you can do Sanzu and Richard. Because talent trees does make a difference at some point. And thank you very much for your donation. But I would recommend to get that Richard first. The reason being the following. Once you get the stars to get Richard, when you're gonna go on the field, Sanzu will be a target. KVK1, maybe not. If you play very careful and don't get dragged in very far away. But if you put Richard first, people tend not to target Richard so much unless they are out of options or you're just very close to them. That's why Richard, you know, it's very good on the murder balls, helps a lot. That's why a lot of people also play infantry, because Richard is not being a target. So they just can play for a, they can play for a very long time in the murder ball. Do Sanzu and Richard. But you can expect a lot of severely wounded, just to be very well aware. Because you have a lot of rage restoration and heal, and not so much defense. And you can expect heavy pains. Any other options I would try with Sanzu, so I can give you that option as well. If you have Diao Chan, or if you have a 5-5 Mehmed, or if you have a Max Ethelfled, you can go with Sanzu. Or you could do that level 50 Richard. Don't get me wrong. Listen, my Richard is level 50, and I don't have him at 6 star. So you can try this talent tree that I have on my Richard. You can take a picture of it. And you can do Richard and Ethelfled, or you can do Richard and someone else. So you can make two infantry pairs. You can go with Sanzu, have a damaging pair, and then you can have a buffing debuffing pair, like even Richard and John, even if it's level 50. Minamoto, you should pair him with other Cav commanders, if you have Minamoto. Yeah, you can go Richard first and you can go John second. And you can put that Sanzu with someone else. You can make, like, you know, a full AoE damaging pair with Sanzu first. And that way Richard is going to be the defensive march and you play more careful with your Sanzu. Is Richard good? 5-1-1, maybe up to KVK1, but after that, no. 5-5 is the minimum I would use Richard. RX usable as once 5-5? Yes, it is. Alright, so he has Alcid, and what did I say that I want to try? Oh, with Ramses, with Tomiris. Alright, so Ramses and Tomiris. Was it a full march? Oh yeah, it was a full march. He also has special archers. I don't think that will make a very big difference. Oh, I got the heal right off the bat. Look at that. RNG. Oh no, he got damage. Bring it on. Don't worry. Oof. Oh boy. Is my time for ass whoopage? I guess so. I noticed that Minamoto has become way more squishy later. Did they nerf him? No, they didn't nerf him. It's the commanders and the equipment, the extra stats that make a difference. Chandra being nerfed out of the game? No, Chandra is still the same. Very too low spender, and I have Richard and Alex expertise. What should I go for next? Expertise commanders. Well, if you have Richard and Alex, then the next one I would recommend you is Guan Yu. Since you're going heavy on infantry, get Guan Yu done and get a 5511 Constantine done as well. A 5511 Leonidas can also help you. In theory, he should have advantages over me because he has the skill talent tree, he generates more rage. I have the attack talent tree. But I do have Ramses first. And Tomiris, with the Tomiris debuff, I'm pretty much making Ramses' defense mean nothing when I do my skill damages. It's just I'm not getting so many stacks whenever I hit him. Oh, I went first on red. Oh my god. So the interruptions from LC is paying off towards the end, I guess. That was 40 minutes ago. So LC is better than Tomiris, ladies and gentlemen. What? Genghis and Ishida? I'm not even gonna fight you. LC than Tomiris. I'm guessing the race restoration made a difference on this one. I'm also believing that the pendant doesn't work. The 5% skill damage from the pendant doesn't work. El Cid is better than most, I think. El Cid is underrated. He does have a lot of defense, yo. El Cid and Ramses is very defensive. What do you think of Richard with Alex? Richard with Alex? That's a very good, well-known combo. Yeah, he had 32,000 left. I even done more healing than he did. For some reason. I won in Archer attack, that's obvious, because I have the 30% from Tomiris. He won in defense by 22% and in health by 7%. Did he use an Archer health skin? I'm guessing he used an Archer health skin. And 22 defense, probably different talent trees, I suppose. There you have it. Don't look down on my boy Ishida. Alright, I'm not gonna look down on your boy Ishida. 240,000. And here we have El Cid and Tomiris. Who should we try against El Cid and Tomiris? Last try. Last try against El Cid and Tomiris. What options do you all say? 202 Archer defense, that's really good. Yeah, that's a lot of defense. He wants to try Ishida. Genki Sento Miris? No, that's Cavs. Rav, I have a 5-5-2-5 Richard. Should I continue on Richard? Well, at this point, yes, you should expertise your Richard. I have 73 heads universal. Well, get your Richard done. Or you can get Alex 5-5, but in the end, Rav, 2019, make sure you finish your Richard. No, I want Attila Alex. Attila Alex against... I'm not sure how... Alright, I'm gonna smash this guy. There's no reason. Well, stop bringing your freaking Ramses. You only bring Ramses, because you know you lose with anything else. Since he learned about Ramses, that's all he does. Oh, he's going somewhere else. He's going to fight with Kami. Ramses versus Ramses. Let's see. Attila and Alex. Alright, I'm gonna try against that LC then Tomiris. Attila and Alex. Someone wants to see Attila and Alex. Attila and Alex. Was it 210? Out. Oh no! No, hold on. Scout. God damn it, let me scout him again. I think it was 210. Yeah, 210. Dan, hey, hello! Oh no, I got hit by the YSG. You gotta be kidding me! Hundred severely wounded. Not fair. The YSG value, ladies and gentlemen, is unbeatable. I really like Constantine John as a support march. Yeah, Constantine John is really great for support, but that's it. Same as Richard and John, they're just very good for support. Ronnie, I mean NT25 Kingdom, 98 Lost Kingdom, and you saw how, yeah, I've done the video about it. Try Centurion Markswoman. Alright, Attila and Alex. Tomiris on her expertise also reduced the attack on calves. So this should help a little, I guess. Alright, let's see. I got instant damage, 2000 right off the bat. Alright, interruption. Skill damage. 5000! Whoa, that was a big hit from Alex. And Glocka won again. He's using the 5% attack city skin. Alright, I'm winning for sure. LC then Tomiris. Yeah, I'm not gonna give him a lot of severely wounded, it's not worth it. I got on yellow, but... Alex has a lot of utilities. I mean, it's not necessary that you have to put it with Attila. You know, that's why I try to avoid using Alex combinations, because he's very versatile. He's very useful everywhere. I would have won, 100%. Let's see the report. Oh yeah, I would have just gave him too many severely wounded. It's not worth it. Come on, Glocker. Bring your Ramses. Let's see Attila Alex against your Ramses. Let's see who first goes on yellow. No, that's Attila Ramses. What the? Attila and Alex. Again, Ramses YSG. Marta Leonidas. Okay. Ramses. Whoa, 7,100 right off the bat. Holy smokes. That was a big hit, yo. But he done a lot. he just demolished that player with the AoE. I got him on yellow, but I was the first one on yellow. YSG is doing way too much damage on single target. And Ramses is reducing the defense. He took 50% of my skill damage. He did. Ramses is reducing the defense of the target by 30%, and then you get YSG hitting. You know, that's a very powerful combination on single target. Does Pendant of Eternal Light work then? I don't think it works, to be honest. Next is Alex YSG. No, I'm not trying any next. I'm getting demolished. This time is enough. So it works against Alcid, but it doesn't work against Ramses. I may need to work on Ramses. He is surprising me. He is very good, but he is slow. So in group battles, you need to pay attention, because once people get on you, you're not getting away. Very hardly getting away. But if you're being left alone with Ramses, you can do some damage. And one versus one, yeah, he's the king. He beats any combo one versus one. I got 10,000 more severely wounded. Khan and Alex against Attila Takeda. Marta Leonidas. Expertise your Leo and take him to the field. No, thank you. That would be the waste investment of sculptures I would ever do. Investing on Leonidas. How is your hospital looking? My hospital is looking alright. 322,000. Yeah, it's fine. Do we have any healing buffs? No? Do we have any buffs today at all? Oh, they're probably saving for the ruins tomorrow. Okay. Yeah, because we got ruins in a couple of hours. No, like 12 hours, give or take. Alright, y'all, I think that's pretty much about this live stream. I mean, I had a lot of fun. I tried a lot of pairs, fought with 46 as well. had some fun with demos too. Why isn't loading my activity? Okay, now it's finally loading. John, thank you very much for your donation. Partnon as well, thank you very much for your donation. Pramo, thank you very much for becoming a member to the channel. Samuel Rivera and L Mac, thank you as well. You have no idea how much I appreciate you all for helping me and for your donations and everyone else being here in chat, for your likes and everything else. Gonna end this live stream with a smile on my face. Were there any donations that I missed? Mean Machine, hold on, I do have to go on Streamlabs, my apologies. I missed the donation from Mean Machine. I didn't have my headset on. Let's see, donation history. Mean Machine, like and subscribe. Thank you very much for your donation, brother. And Hatem, nice new look. So someone appreciates me for shaving. Thank you very much, Hatem. I hope you all have a nice weekend. I'm not sure if I'm going to live stream tomorrow morning at 8, 9 in the morning. I might just live stream. I mean, I'm definitely going to wake up for ruins. I can't miss the ruins. If you want to see more action, then see you in the morning. Hopefully, I will wake up and live stream. Until next time, this is your boy LeJeroni signing off. Peace out, yo, and take care. See you on the next one, and stay safe out there, my friends. Have a good one.